Hank, a fitness instructor, currently lives in Taipei with three other roommates. Moving from Taoyuan to Taipei, Hank shared his thoughts on his living conditions in Taipei City.
我月薪的话，6万到8万之间，我们这层的话，总共3晚，那我们就是3个人对分，平分这样，所以大概一个月租金大概10000到12000以加水电这样子。
Even though Hank is able to live a quite comfortable life with his current salary, he pointed out some long-term problems regarding the gap between wages and high living costs.
目前的收入的话算 OK， 但是就是生活方面是 OK 啊。那如果假如说你是有目标想要什么，买一些比较大的东西，比如说像车子、房子，或者说你想要组织家庭的话，可能就是会比较吃紧啊。Whether
it be locals in Taipei City or those who head to the city to seek new job opportunities. The rising rent and real estate prices and comparatively low wages have prevented young talents from having substantial savings.
薪水可能这十几年来都没有调涨啊，但物价又一直飞升，那在台北生活就很不容易啊。就是觉得什么都贵啊，薪水跟那个物价不太符合。台北物价比较高，可能4万到5万吧。
论房租的话，大概4吧，3万5以上吧。4到5万，
每个月花。
食衣住行，再加上通信娱乐，基本上睁开眼睛的每一天都在花钱。尤其呢是在台北市，物价更是高居全台之冠。到底要多少的月薪才能达到基本的生活品质？以上都是网络上的热门话题。According
to a local report, the average monthly expense per person in 2020 is around NT$20,000. Monthly expenses in Zhanghua County were the lowest in Taiwan, with an average of NT$17,794. 新竹 County placed second highest in Taiwan, with the citizens spending an average of NT$26,661 per month. However, none is as high as Taipei City, which was the only city to surpass the NT$30,000 benchmark, as residents spend NT$30,713 per month on average. Experts have since predicted that just like neighboring countries, the average cost of living in Taiwan, regardless of city or county, will only become higher.
东京那边的话，听说是一趟的通勤时间大概1个半小时，那来回就要3个小时，每天哦。那台北市未来大概会变成这个样子，也就工作地点都在这些大都会，可是我住的时候是在邻近的卫星城市，不只有台北市的生活成本越来越高。 当外来从台北市搬出去的人，比如到林口，你到新庄，只要人一进去，当地的租金就跟着涨，涨以后呢，店租就跟着涨，生活成本就跟着涨，所以这种东西它会从台北市这种所谓的高成本、高生活成本的这样的一个现象，会从台北市继续往外扩散出去，那这种东西就变成你逃无可逃了。Low
wages, rising cost of living, and the decrease in birth rate altogether. Make this an interlocking problem that Taiwan desperately needs to address soon. TVBS English News.